Breaking news, my lovely, wonderful people. Former governor of Kogi State, Yahaya Bello, has been picked up by the EFCC in a midnight raid. Contrary to, you know, words that are going on that, oh, he voluntarily, you know, went to see the EFCC. No, they sought for him, raided Lokoja, and they found him. So this is exactly what is going on now. And everybody is watching and want to see what the next line of action is. Everybody is watching, and you know, Yahaya Bello and Tinubu had a serious issue when he told Tinubu, Tinubu will never become president. So Tinubu was waiting for him very patiently. Tinubu has made up his mind to ensure that he deal with him, despite the fact that they are the same party. The dealing with him did not end there. Yahaya Bello arrested in a midnight raid. EFCC denied claim of surrender. He did not surrender. We caught him. He's in their custody now as we speak. Yahaya Bello State was the state where we saw that, you know, before the election took place, the result was already out. And everybody was waiting. You know, everybody was waiting to see, you know, what will follow next. Anyway, my lovely people, this is what is happening. Please don't forget to give us a thumbs up, like us, share, subscribe. The Economic and Financial Crime Commission, EFCC, has taken the former Kogi State Governor, Yahaya Bello, into custody following a midnight raid operation in Lokoja. Contrary to earlier reports suggesting that Bello voluntarily surrendered, reliable sources from the EFCC confirmed his arrest. He was arrested. He did not surrender. The case is ongoing as the EFCC continues its investigation. Immediate past governor of Kogi State, Yahaya Bello, has been arrested by the Economic and Financial Crime Commission, EFCC, in Abuja. According to sources from the EFCC, the arrest took place during a midnight operation in Lokoja, despite earlier claim from Bello's camp that he voluntarily honored the EFCC's invitation. There was no such thing. The EFCC source stated that Bello was tracked down and arrested at midnight. He is now in custody at the EFCC headquarters in Abuja. Meanwhile, a statement from Michael, director of Yahaya Bello's media office, maintained that the former governor had willingly appeared before the EFCC after consulting with his legal team and family. Michael also ascertained that Bello, who was consistently advocated for transparency during his tenure, was committed to clearing his name in the ongoing investigation. The specifics of the investigations have not been disclosed to the general public. However, EFCC is expected to release more details in the coming days, as APC is keeping this very close to their chest, knowing fully well that they are of the same party. They want to deal with Yahaya Bello, however, do not want to expose themselves. With the former governor's legal team involved, the new development emerging reveal how this high-profile case unfold more details in the forthcoming days. Everyone is expected to see how these things will play out. Nigerians are watching carefully to see what will be the next turn of event. With Yahaya Bello currently now in custody, everybody's watching to see how, you know, people will begin to, the government of Nigeria will handle this. They've not told us categorically, you know, all, you know, that he has been accused of, but these are some of the things that are going on. Well, my people, can you see that? It is important we all stick together as one and do not allow lies to manipulate us. The people who are doing this, they all know exactly what they are doing. Every one of them, they are the same people. Okay? They all know exactly what they are doing. And the truth of it is, until we all arise together and ensure that all these lies are, you know, are destroyed, we don't know how soon. Okay? We don't know how soon we're going to be getting the very truth out of a system that has become corrupt. Yahaya Bello, even why as the governor, we know that in Lagos, they saw Kogi State money, and he was there to quickly tell them that, oh, the money is not for Kogi State. They said, so where did the money come from? He could not speak. He could not speak where the money came from. He could not speak. You know, him and Tinubu have been, you know, they have been at, you know, loggerheads. And this is exactly what is happening. This is exactly what is happening. Okay? Everybody's watching and want to know exactly what, you know, these things will be and how they will unfold. We cannot continue with the same thing over and over again and expect a different result. Nigerians, if we're going to be honest and tell ourselves the truth, we all have to stick together. It's not just Yahaya Bello that is the one who needs to be arrested. Many of them. Yahaya Bello is the least now. He's the least in the line. They all know exactly what they are doing. They are all the same. They are all, you know, a bird of a feather. They all flock together. They know exactly what they are doing. A nation where, you know, a nation that has some of the greatest wealth, but yet the people lives in penury, and you are charging them at the rate of dollar, and they are eating like, you know, they are eating like peasants. No, that's not done. And one person will collect the whole wealth of a nation, and everybody will be quiet. Excuse me. Something needs to be done to end all these abnormalities. Please leave us a comment. Don't forget to please like us, share, subscribe, click on the notification button so you can get all our latest news. God bless. Have a lovely and a fantastic day. From us, it's bye for now. Bye-bye. The days are upon us, so every single person must ensure that we do everything, you know, decently and in order. We must speak out and we must ensure that the same thing does not continue over and over again. If every one of us will be honest and tell ourselves the truth, at the end of the day, we will know those who are truly, you know, for this nation and those who are destroying the very essence of this nation. Whether you like it or not, they know who Yahaya Bello is. I can assure you for free. They know. But they will pretend as if they are not aware. They know. So these are some of the people that we have. These are some of the things that are happening. And everybody just needs to begin to ensure that we speak out and you know. And Yahaya Bello, we want to know what the crime is, what and what he has done. We need to know. The Tinubu's administration needs to tell us. They need to tell us. They cannot continue to pretend and to hide. They must tell us, fighting themselves secretly. No, we want to know. Please don't forget to give us a thumbs up, like us, share, subscribe. Click on the notification button so you can get all our latest news. Remember, you have a voice. God bless. Have a fantastic and a lovely day. From us, it's bye for now. Bye-bye. Remember that everybody, you know, have a decision to make in ensuring that we join forces and end, you know, every abnormality going on. You know, it is important. Nigerians, we all must stand up together as one. Bye for now.